It's that time of the year again when Premiere Pro comes out with the latest version, 2025. Now, the big question on everyone's mind is it worth upgrading to the latest version? So in this video, I'm going to be reviewing all the new features that are coming out this year and seeing if it's worth upgrading or not. Leave your comments down below as we go through the new features and let me know what you guys think down in the comments section below. Let's get into it. One of the newest features and things you'll notice right away is that they updated the new project button. So when you click on it, you'll notice that you get granted with a new dialog box. So this is more simplified. You can just name your project, choose the location, choose from a template that you've already created. For example, I have a tutorial template when I create these tutorials, and you can get started right away by clicking on this checkbox, skip import mode. So I like this feature. I don't really use the import mode that often. So if you want to just skip the import mode, you can check on this box and that'll just go right into the edit menu and you can start right away editing inside Premiere Pro. But if you still want the import mode, you can uncheck it. Now there is also this gear icon where you can choose some general settings for your project. But overall, that's a new feature when it comes to the new project dialog box. So I'm gonna check on skip import mode and then click create. All right, so we're inside Premiere Pro 2025. One of the new features that you'll notice right away is that they updated the interface quite a bit. The audio meters is a little bit different. I think it's a little darker of a background so you can clearly see when there's audio and when there's not audio. The tools panel, you can see each item selected in blue. So it's very obvious which tool is selected. So just some minor UI changes inside the latest update of Premiere Pro. I like them, but leave your comments down below on your thoughts so far on these new UI features. One thing that you can adjust that has changed inside Premiere Pro is the appearance. So let's say if you go up to Premiere Pro settings appearance, they took away the slider where you can change how dark or light it is. They replaced it with three different color themes. So you can choose light, dark, or darkest. So you can choose one of those as well as this button underneath, accessible color contrast. So you can choose that. And this just changes the contrast a little bit. So you can choose whichever setting you prefer. And that's one of the new features inside 2025. Another new feature inside Premiere Pro 2025 is that they added an import media button directly inside the project panel. So I started this project from scratch. There's no imported media. To import your media, you can just click on this button. So you don't have to go up to file import, double click in the panel. It's a one click import button. And you can navigate to some media and import it in your project. For example, I'm gonna go and navigate and import some footage here. I'm just gonna click and drag one of these clips into the sequence so we have something to work with here. All right, so one of the new features that you should be aware of before you update to version 2025 is that they updated the graphics quite a bit. So they added two new panels, the graphics templates panel and the properties panel. So if we take a look at the graphics templates panel, this is essentially where you go to install your MoGurts, your motion graphics templates. This is essentially that panel. So at the top right, you can import your MoGurt. You can add additional folders. So this essentially looks the same. Say if we click and drag this graphic into our timeline, just so we have something here, it operates the same way as essential graphics. But to edit this graphic, if we click on it, you have to pull up the properties panel. If you don't see the properties panel, you can go up to window properties. And once again, window graphics templates. If you don't see graphics templates displayed, these two panels essentially replace the essential graphics panel. So if we go to the properties panel, this will be brought up. And as you can see, it's very similar to essential graphics, is where you can change out the fonts, the text, and make adjustments. Now, what's nice about this panel is it's not only just for graphics, but you can also use this for clips as well. So if you click on a clip, you can see that transform options, crop options, and even options to change the audio is displayed inside the properties panel, which is really nice. They even have a button at the bottom left to adjust the speed, which is nice. So you don't have to right click, go to clip speed and duration, or hit Command R. But essentially this properties panel is very similar to the After Effects properties panel. So if you're familiar with that, it kind of mirrors that whichever clip is selected in your timeline, it'll display the most appropriate properties in that panel so that you can adjust them. In addition to the properties panel, they made some updates to effects controls as well. So if we hop over to effects controls, they made it more obvious at the top left where you can change it from source to the clip level. So if you apply effects to the clip rather than the source, you can change it at the top. It's very noticeable. Before, it was a little bit more hidden. Same with the color. If you go into, let's say, we change our workspace to color, it's more obvious at the top right here, whether you're working on the source clip or the clip itself in the timeline. That's a minor UI change that I really like. But going back to effects controls, what you'll notice inside the effects controls under motion is that they added crop fields directly inside the motion parameter. So this is really nice. You can automatically add a crop effect to your footage directly inside effects controls rather than having to go to the effects panel. So let's say if we go to effects and we have to type in crop, then we would have to click and drag this down to our clip. And then this is added as an effect that we would then edit. It's directly already inside the motion parameters, which is really nice. In addition to that, they also added a nice button at the bottom left of the program monitor. So if we take a look at this new button at the bottom left here, you can enable and toggle direct manipulation here. So if you click on it, you can then size down your clip. So you can size it down, size it up. You can also rotate it. So if you click and drag the corners, you can rotate your clip as well as cropping. So if you click on the drop down, you can change it from transform to crop. And now you can actually crop your footage as well directly inside the program monitor, which is really nice. Now, another new feature that's really cool that's inside the beta version of Premiere Pro is Generative Extend. This new feature allows you to extend video or audio clips by using AI. Let's take a look at how this works. This is pretty cool. All right, so I'm inside Premiere Pro beta, and as we can see, I have this video clip of me and I want to extend it. You know, I can't really extend it. It's at the end of the clip, but using this new feature, Generative Extend, we can extend our clip using AI. So you'll see the new tool listed at the bottom here, Generative Extend. So if we click on it, we can then click and drag out to the right to extend the clip. You'll also notice that right here, you can see a generating loading bar. So once this is complete, we can see what we have. All right, so once it's complete, you can see that you have this AI generated tab right here. Let's play this back and see what we have. So you can see it just extended it a little bit. It's still in beta and still needs some refining. You'll notice that it kind of lightens a little bit. So when we go from this clip to the AI generated clip, you can see it kind of lightens it quite a bit. Now, say if you want to regenerate it, you can always right click on the AI generation here and go to generate again. You can also provide feedback by clicking on good output or poor output and provide Adobe feedback on their AI tool. Now, to fix the exposure issue, I recommend getting your razor tool and just making a cut there, and maybe clicking on this clip and just knocking down your exposure by like 0.2. And that should solve the problem a little bit there. You can see there's a slight cut, but it kind of matches a little bit better. But that's a really cool tool. It's still in beta, but once it comes out in the full release of Premiere Pro, it'll be an exciting tool to use inside video editing projects. Now, this also works for audio as well. You can extend like room tone and different sound effects. And for music, if you need to extend music, there's also already the remix tool that you can use right away inside Premiere Pro. If you want to learn how to use the remix tool inside Premiere Pro, I did make a video going over it. I will link that video right up there. But that does it for this video. Welcome to Premiere Pro 2025, and leave your comments down below on your thoughts so far. That does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.